Okay, Earl, it's a video for you. It's not quite a YouTube drinking community video. It's not really a malt liquor video. We don't have malt liquor here in Ireland that I'm aware of. This is Guinness, and it's made with unmalted barley. Malt liquor, according to Wikipedia, is any beer over 6%, 6 or 7% alcohol by volume. This is only a puny 4.2%. Most beers in Ireland are about 5.2, around that. So it's not malt liquor and it's not very strong, which is the first thing going against it. That doesn't seem right for me to be saying those words. There's nothing wrong with Guinness. Second thing going against it, I'll explain here. Now, even this isn't draft, it's draft can. I don't need a two-stage pouring that you would normally do in a pub. But as I pour that, you will start to see where the problems arise. I don't know how well that's going to be made out on the screen there. If it's chemical reactions going on here, there's nitrogen bubbles being created and there's convection currents happening and it's settling out into this really cool foam. Now, I can't start drinking that like you open a bottle of Mickey's and start drinking. With Guinness, you have to let it settle. You don't rush a Guinness. So that's one thing that kind of keeps me from emulating what you do the way you do it. But I'm not trying to compete. I don't compete with drinking. I haven't done for a long while. That gives me a bit of time to collect my thoughts and start rolling a little cigarette. So there's not really a drinking video. I'm going to be drinking during this, but it's not a race. I'm not going to try and finish it within 5 minutes. This video could take me 20 minutes of film, and I might not be finished that point, which is settling nicely. I'll tell you why I wanted to make a video to you. Now, it was when I watched your video last week, or a couple of days ago, when you turned 45, and you just had a video of yourself down in the Delta, with that cool jacket you have on, and your hat, and you had a can. You had a can of Colt 45, was that it? I gave you a comment at the time, but there's something about the visuals of that. They were just stunning, I thought. It was cinematic in its feeling when I looked at it. And that's something about your videos that I've always, always loved. When you bring us down to the Delta. I don't know what Delta it is. I don't even know what river you're on. But I just love seeing the paths you walk down and listening to the stories you come up with as you're walking yourself and Akela. And in your video, you turn 45, I think this is ready now. I can't look at it, it's like a kid waiting for Christmas. Oh yeah. Oh, can't beat it, can't beat it. Keep your Mickeys. alright, your video. At the start of your video, there's lovely, lovely sentiments at the start. It was your birthday, but you're complimenting us, everyone out there. The good qualities about us is something you want to emulate yourself. And I just give that right back to you, Earl. You've got tons of really nice qualities that I would like to emulate myself. I'm not going to list them all now. This is not a circle jerk or anything like that. But yeah, I like your attitude, Earl. I like the way you have decided to live your life. That small house, that tiny house thing, brilliant. I'd never heard of that movement until I saw your videos. And it got me thinking. It's the kind of solution, a housing solution, that it's going to work for me eventually. If I had the bit of land, which is quite expensive here. But yeah, I can quite easily see myself following in your footsteps there at some point. You've got, I think, a pretty cool life. I don't know how accurate that is, but that's how it comes across. You're surrounded by amazing scenery. You've got a cool little house. You have your dog. You don't take your work too seriously. And going by your stories, you've lived a fairly interesting and varied life so far. You've travelled quite a lot. You've travelled more than I have, for sure. And you cycled. I love that. I cycled around Europe myself about 20 years ago now. And I've cycled around Ireland once or twice. The next kind of adventurous kind of thing I plan to do is to walk from Malinhead to Mizenhead, the top to the bottom of Ireland. And it's going to be at least next year before that happens. It was planned for this year, but that fell through. To be honest with you, I'll start with this. I don't really have anywhere to go with it. Sorry about that. I just really feel right now what I feel like doing is just knocking his back, having another one, and watching a film. To be honest with you, it's not that I've run out of interest in you halfway through my own video to you. But that's what this does to me. This makes me want to just sit back and not be doing something like editing a video and uploading it to YouTube. So I'll leave it here. Do you know what? I'll take this up with you again. I'll direct something to you again. I'll bring you somewhere a bit more exciting than this room. It's night time here, so I can't bring you out and about. But yeah, there's some cool places around here. I'll bring you along, and I'll have a few more words for you then. But in the meantime, after this video, as a companion piece to this one, there's a video clip I put together last week after watching that 45th birthday thing, and how, you know, like, I was really struck by the cinematic nature and the quality of that shot of you in that coat, in that environment, and the woman walking her dogs in the background was perfect. Perfect, and the sound of their chains in the background and the rain. You did a perfectly good choice to keep that up, to not put a soundtrack to that. But as soon as you said that, or you wrote that in one of the comments, I think, or in the description, you decided not to leave this, not to add music to it. As soon as I read that, I started thinking, well, yeah, of course, this is begging out for some music. And a song came to mind straight away. So I went and I played it, and I played the two together, and they matched really well. So I went on, and I spent about 2 days looking at a lot of your videos. Oh, sorry, come on, you bugger. Yeah, I spent about 2 days last week looking at a ton of your old videos and putting together one of those video montage things, which I love doing from time to time, but I haven't done it in a long while, actually. I like doing those slideshow videos and a bit of music, but also is it, yeah, montage. It's got to be montage, that's what it would be. And I was reminded of a presentation I'd seen from one of the top guys in Google about new features on Google Plus for videos, where they, if you, not really aimed at people like us who are you know, like video creators or content creators, whatever you want to call us, really, who are up making their own videos. It's a feature of Google Plus that's designed for people who go to the beach maybe and they take four or five small little 10, 15 second video clips of there's the dog running and there's somebody falling down, that kind of stuff. And it'll take your videos, mash them up, put them to sound, edit them so that the action in the video matches the beats and the music, and it'll throw in some and do this automatically for you. It'll auto awesome, that's what they call it. Auto awesome movies. And I remember when I listened to him saying that, I thought I had a strong reaction against it, because these are the decision on when to cut from one scene to another, or what piece of music works, or when to have a photograph, or those decisions, as somebody who makes videos, it's like I had a very strong reaction against the very idea that that would happen. I said, that's what I want to do, that's part of why I do it, you know, this is when I make videos like that. So instead of auto awesoming, I just awesomed. I made you an awesome video just trawling back through your own back catalogue. And it's a great excuse to go back and look at videos that I haven't seen of yours, like from right back. I went right back to the start. Nothing embarrassing, don't worry about that. I've literally made you awesome. Awesomer, put it that way. Oh yeah, lovely. I'm making a liar out of myself now, because this is going down far too quickly. I have now what we call a goo on me. I have a goo on me for more. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go down, knock this back, go down and get another can, and start editing this fucking thing. There's no swilling that stuff there. It doesn't go down. Stays in the glass. Ugh. So, Earl. See you in the tubes.